What is up, guys? This is IFBB Pro Jeremy Dutra here, and I am officially 7 days out of my pro debut. It's Saturday, show is next Saturday in San Diego. So I'm gonna walk you through this entire week. We'll call this day one of peak week. So we're at the gym right now. Ain't nobody here. I'm the first one here, only one here. I'm gonna walk up here. I'm gonna do about 45 minutes of cardio. What I like to do when I do my cardio is either listen to some audiobooks, watch Netflix, watch some Amazon Prime. Today I'm listening to Blinks. If you guys don't know what Blinkist is, it's an app where you get to listen to different books. I like audiobook style, but it kind of summarizes the book. So I can listen to 3 or 4 or 5 books while I do my cardio. That's what I'm gonna do today. And yeah, this is gonna be my first time kind of recording everything I do during peak week. All of my peak weeks are different. We'll be heading out to San Diego on Wednesday with my client Ram, who's doing a show a couple weeks after mine. So it'll be good for him to kind of see, you know, where, what happens. So let's get up in here, let's do this cardio. So we're up on the treadmill. The way I'm doing my cardio is incline walk at 10% incline. I started at about a 3 speed, and then I bump it up to about a 3.5, 3.6, 3.7. And we also gotta make sure that our watch is going. I check on my Apple Watch. I have a lot of people use their Apple Watch to track. It's not the most accurate thing to use to track calories, but it's accurate to itself. So if it's every day you're hitting 1500 calories in your move goal, that's what I'm looking for, right? It's accurate to itself. So we're gonna do this 30 and listen to some Blinks. And I'll see you at the first meal. Egg whites, spinach from the microwave. Let's go. All right, guys, so we did the 45 minutes. We just did 20 minutes in posing, took some videos, and now we're waiting on the client. It's 6:23, she's supposed to be here a little earlier, do some cardio before we start at 7. I'm not quite hungry yet, so I'm gonna push my meal back until after I train her. I'm gonna drink water right now, I'm having another cup of coffee, and just kinda chill. When I get this deep into prep, man, I really try to separate my meals as far as I can in terms of hunger. I really try to push the hunger as far as I can. Because this close to the show, I'm not looking to build muscle. I'm looking to get as many calories as I need to function. That's about it. To function, keep my body in an anabolic state with protein, but the carbs, super low. Fats, super low. So mostly protein, vegetables, really depleting. And if you do that process correctly, the carb up can't go wrong, man. If you understand how to deplete correctly, if you understand water and salt correctly, man, the carb up just becomes fun because you get to really just really pig out, honestly. Diet's over as soon as you start putting some carb in your body. So because I got this time, I'm gonna drink coffee, do a little bit more stretching just because I got the time, and wait on my client. I will see you. I'll probably show a video or two of her killing it because she's a beast. Shout out Colette. And then I'll see you guys at my first meal. Alrighty, so trained Colette. She's actually doing a little bit more cardio because my clients get results, yo. Finished my third coffee. Been up since 3:30. It's 8:30. Time to get the first meal in. First meal is real boring. Typically I'm home, I saute up my vegetables together. Add the egg whites, add the salmon, but we lowering fats, lowering carbs, even lowering fiber a little bit. So we gotta microwave some egg whites,
and put on a bed of spinach. That's what we got. So,
all right, guys. So, I'm gonna make this meal real quick. I got a Tupperware full of spinach here. Got my scale. Got my egg whites. We are going with 8 ounces of egg whites. This one's a little turn on. Cool. 8 ounces. I'm just gonna pour this right on top of the spinach. So I'm gonna cook it all together. And boom, right? Put the egg whites in there. Now we're just gonna cook this down. Throw it in the microwave, maybe like 2-ish minutes. I don't do this very often, so I don't really know how long it's gonna take. We'll throw it in there, 2 minutes. Let's go. Okay, so eggs come out of the microwave and that's what it looked like, right? Cooked right on top of my spinach. We don't just eat it plain. I mean, any of my meals plain, come on. Yeah, we're carb depleting, but we gotta have some of that Gaines poppy sauce. If you ain't anything messing with this is Gaines Bakery in Texas. They make this poppy sauce. It's a diet hack sauce. I literally put on everything. Check them out, Gaines Bakery. I got a discount code too, JD10, if you wanna use it. If not, just buy their stuff. You'll never wanna get off your diet. So I'm just gonna go and throw some of that on top. It's all sugar free. Bam. Got my meal, meal one. Let's go. All right, so as I eat here, sit here and eat my first meal I want to talk to you guys about. Making it work, right? I've had great clients and I've had some clients that fall off pretty easily because something like this, they'll be out and about and they'll have shit to do. They're like, oh, I just couldn't get a meal in. I just couldn't figure it out. Like, what do I eat? Okay. That question, before you ask your coach, ask yourself, what was in my meal? Oh, I was supposed to eat egg whites and spinach. Okay, so what was the meal? Protein. It's protein with no fat and some vegetables. That's how your brain should work. So, damn, like I forgot my eggs or I forgot my vegetables. What can I eat, right? I need a really clean protein source. You can stop at the store. You can stop at 7-Eleven. You can stop by Vaughn, Safeway, and grab deli meat, right? You can grab a bag of spinach. Right, you can make it work. You can stop at a gas station, probably find something, you know? Probably find some like turkey jerky or some shit. Right, you have to make it work. There's no missing meals over here. You know, oh, I couldn't figure it out. Like, I didn't have enough time. Get up earlier and prep your meals. Like, it's like the worst thing as a coach. You get a text, I'm like, I'll text my clients like, hey, how you doing? Oh, I just couldn't eat breakfast somewhere. I was just rushing. Rushing for what? You get up earlier. I don't want to hear this rushing stuff, right? Like, have time. So dumb. You see how much I do. I started this prep 10 weeks ago. You look at the roll call. I've been up every single day before 4:30. I post a roll call at 4:30. Gives me enough time to meditate. Gives me enough time to get drink coffee. Do all the stuff I need to do. Prep meals for the day. Get up early. There's no excuses. Anyway, gonna finish this meal. Go home. Take a nap. Right now it's 9:20, so we kind of space my meals out 3-4 hours, try to stretch as much as I can. So our next meal will probably be around noon 30, and that'll be my pre-workout meal. Now, what are we working out today? What are we working out?
Back.
What did I do back last?
Back.
I do back. Yeah, I think I do back. So, pre-workout meal. About 12, and we'll work out probably around 1:32. All right, so we'll go from that nap. It's now time for the gym. Have my pre-workout meal, cream of rice, protein, salt, peanut butter. I love that meal. Ooh, I love it so much. We're gonna do some back, another 45 minutes of cardio. And yeah. I'm doing cardio now. Ram's here doing his cardio as well. We got a 3.5 speed, 10% incline. Try to hold him on. Not hold as much as I can, but fuck that. I'm so tired, I end up holding on. But get my heart rate up, run the calories. Normally, I don't even know if I'll get the time. I just turn the time off so I can't see it. I'm just gonna walk until we can't walk. Let's go.
Okay, workout's done. Cardio's done. Posing's done. Ram's over here. We posed a little bit with him as well. Dude is shredded. But, we got our next meal. We're gonna go home, tilapia. I don't know how it is. It's not too exciting. We get through this last week, man. It's about so, how much can you suffer? How much can you endure? Put a smile on your face and keep doing it. So, we're gonna drive home. Let's eat.
All right, guys, we're going ahead and make my post-workout meal. It's a big salad. I use this giant salad bowl. I got spinach. I got some regular iceberg in there. Some pickles over here on my stove. Is more vegetable sauteing. It's asparagus, it's mushrooms, bell peppers, 7 ounces of tilapia, little game sauce in there. Nice and hot, goes right on my salad. Sauce it up a little bit, low calorie sauces. Season it, and that's my post-workout meal. Very big volume, but low calorie dense, for most of my meals. So I'm gonna put this on there and show you the finished product.
Guys, and there we are. I'm gonna top this off with a little bit of this nacho cheddar popcorn seasoning. I got some mustard on there, some sugar-free barbecue sauce. Bam, it's like a 3-pound meal. And we'll eat this. We're gonna go chill for about an hour, 2 hours, and then go back to the gym and hit this cardio.
All right, guys, so third cardio session. Didn't realize the gym's closed so early on the weekends. So I'm here in my stairwell. We're doing stairs, 30 minutes. Just gonna get it done by any means necessary. We got 30 minutes and one last meal in about an hour. So let's get this, let's get to that next meal. All right, guys, that is it. Did my third session of cardio. Had my last meal, another salad. Just even too tired to film it. But that is day one of peak week, Saturday. We have 7 days, so tomorrow gets a little tougher because we kept carbs out completely. So I'll be able to get that pre-workout carbs. So the depletion process, and slowly add carbs midweek as my body starts to change. So that is 7 days out, pro debut. We'll see you guys in the next video.